Australian cricket stalwart David Warner announced on Monday his decision to retire from one-day international cricket, a move that comes ahead of his final test match against Pakistan this week. The veteran opener, who played a pivotal role in Australia's 2023 World Cup triumph in India as the leading run scorer, expressed that the timing is appropriate to bring his ODI career to a close. Warner had been contemplating retirement even before the World Cup, and he officially disclosed his decision during a press conference ahead of his farewell test at the SCG. Despite stepping back from ODIs, the 37-year-old clarified that his cricket journey will continue and he has made himself available for select tournaments, notably targeting participation in the 2025 Champions Trophy. Addressing the media in Sydney, David Warner expressed his decision to step away from one-day international cricket, emphasizing the importance of dedicating more time to his family. He stated, "I've got to give back to the family, and also on back of that, I'm definitely retiring from one-day cricket as well." Warner had communicated this intention during the 2023 World Cup, and with Australia securing victory in India, he considers it a significant achievement. Despite bidding farewell to ODIs, Warner disclosed his plans to continue playing in select T20 leagues worldwide. He also highlighted his availability for the upcoming Champions Trophy, stating, "If I am playing decent cricket in 2 years' time and I am around and they need someone, I am going to be available." Warner retires as the sixth highest run scorer in Australian ODI history, having amassed 6,932 runs from his 161 matches. His 22 centuries are the second most by any Australian ODI player, behind only Ricky Ponting, who made 29 in 105 more innings than Warner played. David Warner elaborated on his decision to retire from ODIs, highlighting the potential for increased participation in franchisee cricket on the international stage. He expressed a keen interest in continuing his involvement in the Big Bash League, maintaining an existing contract with the Sydney Thunder until the conclusion of the current season. While Warner has been a consistent presence in the Indian Premier League since 2009, he mentioned that due to a hectic international schedule, he has not participated in leagues such as the Pakistan Super League or England's The 100. Warner did, however, play one season each in the Caribbean Premier League and Bangladesh Premier League before the COVID-19 pandemic. Warner's final test match begins on Wednesday at his home ground, where Australia have the chance to complete a 3-0 series whitewash against Pakistan. Before the World Test Championship final and Ashes over the Australian winner, Warner flagged his intention to call time after the Sydney test, a plan that was deemed self-indulgent by some vocal critics. Known for his larger-than-life persona, David Warner earned high praise from Australia coach Andrew McDonald, who referred to him as probably our greatest ever three-format player over the weekend. However, Warner's cricket journey is also marked by his involvement in the infamous ball tampering scandal of 2018 in South Africa. Alongside skipper Steve Smith, Warner faced a one-year ban for his role in the third test controversy in Cape Town, where Cameron Bancroft used sandpaper to alter the ball, followed by an unsuccessful attempt to hide the evidence in his trousers. The incident had significant repercussions for Australian cricket and left an indelible mark on Warner's career. Reflecting on his test career, Warner said it was a fairy tale ending to hang up his gloves in Sydney. He added that he would like to be remembered as someone authentic and honest who has gone out there and given it his all.